What's up, People's Universe and my future self? It's been a long time since my last channel update, honestly. It's been almost a month. And I know I don't really make a lot of channel update videos, but it's also true that I haven't uploaded that many videos in these recent weeks. Been busy and just haven't been in the video making mode, you know, where I just like talk to a camera and just talk about whatever I want to talk about. I do have, as you can see in my website, which I promised, I assured myself that I'll be updating quite often, like, you know, solidquan.wordpress.com. I, you know, was intending to use that as a compliment to this, to YouTube, and just kind of update it where, you know, put out my weekly, the videos that I uploaded of all the stuff, you know, the stuff of the week, you know, feature videos of the week posted on there, what projects I'm planning to do, what videos I'm planning to make in the future, stuff like that. So I had it all organized, but I just kind of got lazy and didn't really do much updating. So this is where this channel update comes in, just updating what happened with me this past month, really. And a lot has happened, actually, in the past month. A lot can happen in a month, you know. And one of the things you might notice is that, you know, I'm not surrounded by the PlayStation Eye interface anymore. And that really is because I never really owned a webcam, and that was just my convenient way of doing it without having to spend time on a video editing software or anything like that. But this one, as you can notice, there's a little delay in my motions, at least to me, you know, there's a little, you know, it's not perfect one-on-one like the PlayStation Eye camera is, but that's because this is the MacBook webcam. And that's right, I got my MacBook again. It's not really because I had money saved up. I'm not able to afford a MacBook, really, but I lost my computer. What happened was, I was in the subway station, I took my laptop because I needed to do a group project with one of my classmates, and I left it underneath the train seat, and I was listening to, you know, I got a new iPod too. I've been going crazy spending spree with my credit card lately. That's probably another video topic to do in the future, but yeah, I was on my iPod Touch. I was playing chess, listening to music, and I was deeply absorbed into the chess because the computer opponents, I had the level all the way up, so the computer opponent is extremely difficult, and I was just so frustrated. It's like, maybe I'll win this time, maybe I'll win. I missed my train stop. I didn't know I missed the train stop until I looked up, and I was like, oh shit, I missed my stop. So I got out, forgetting the fact that I left the laptop underneath the train. So there goes my laptop. Of course, I talked to the MTA employee, tried to get him to kind of, well, he was really nice. It was really nice. I was like, you know, I just got out of the train, I left my laptop in there, and, you know, he was like, you know, when did you leave the train? Like, 5 minutes ago. Okay, so this is the train that left 5 minutes ago. He called the train operator and the train and asked if he could find the laptop case, and he wasn't able to. So I'm thinking maybe it wasn't, maybe my timing was off, maybe it was like 10 minutes ago that the train left. But in any case, I wasn't able to find my laptop, and I'm planning to go to the Lost and Found in the tomorrow. But that's why I had to get another computer. Granted, I didn't necessarily have to get a MacBook, because MacBooks are so expensive. But ever since I got my MacBook stolen a year and a half ago, or is it 2 years ago, I've been wanting one ever since. And I figured, I lost a computer, I need a computer, why not? And it's quite funny because I spent the credit card on my iPod Touch, I think I reached my credit limit, so I wasn't able to buy this MacBook with my credit card because it got declined. So what I did was, I, you know, Best Buy, they have their own credit card service deal, so I just applied for that, got approved for $1,400, and used that to buy this MacBook, which is the cheapest model. It's the $999 model. But I have a 3-year warranty on it, and I bought Pages software, so that's why it came to be a total of $1,400. And really, two great products, iPod Touch, I'll talk about later in a future video, and MacBook I don't need to talk about. But yeah, pretty awesome being an Apple person again. I don't know, I always just loved Apple customer service and their products, so I don't know what it is about them, but it's what I love. So that's another thing, and a technical issue. And another thing about my life, which I know this is gonna cause a lot of, I don't know, if anyone is really watching my videos, I mean, no one really is. I just talk to talk because it really helps me develop myself. But another thing is, ever since like March 20-something, 22nd, I believe, I don't really remember the date. Yes, March 22nd is the day I turned vegan. Whoa, right? I mean, nowadays in society, like, the concept of veganism is just so shocking to people, I think. You know, it's like, oh my god, you're vegan? How do you do that? And for a lot of times, I was wondering the same thing, too. I was wondering, like, how can I be vegan without, you know, with it being convenient enough so that I don't have to go out of my way to do all this, and without being so expensive, you know, because a lot of times, a lot of the restaurants and a lot of the fast food and stuff like that, they're so friendly, just, it's so much more convenient to get something with meat in it. And being vegan is hard too, because, you know, there's, you can't drink milk, you can't drink animal milk, let's say that, because, I mean, let's say, like, not a lot of people know that there are so many other kinds of milk, like nut milk, oat milk. Anyway, I'm not going to talk about veganism, but anyway, I turned vegan. So that's probably another video that's going to come up about my experience as a vegan and how I'm really coming to really enjoy this lifestyle. And just, I don't know, it's just really an incredible journey for me right now. And I really can't think why I didn't decide to do this sooner. And I'm also listening to this podcast, and I'm probably going to mention this a lot in my other videos. And this podcast is Vegetarian Food for Thought by Colleen Powell Goodrow. And she's the founder of Compassionate Cooks. And this podcast is just absolutely amazing. So veganism is definitely a topic that I really want to talk about. As far as other things go, let's see. My life is pretty crazy right now. I have 2 final papers to do, but for college, really. But really, this is going to be the last 2 papers that I really ever do for undergrad, because I'm graduating soon. And after graduation, who knows what the fuck's gonna happen. You know, I just don't know yet. My watch is beeping, sorry. Just don't know, because I'm just applying to, I applied to grad school, Long Island University, and I applied for jobs, so I'm just waiting to hear back from them. I don't really know if I want to pursue a job right after undergrad, or if I want to go to grad school, but that's another topic altogether. So that's really my channel update. Oh! And one last thing containing videos, because that's what channel updates about, is actually talking about my YouTube channel, is that I was doing a Lost Odyssey playthrough, right? And I don't know if I can continue it anymore. I mean, I will continue it maybe, but I uploaded part 22. I think that's the last part I uploaded for Lost Odyssey playthrough. But I had in my old the computer that I lost, what I saved was up to part 67, I believe. So I had 67 videos, lost them. I wasn't able to back them up in time because I wasn't expecting that my computer would get lost. So I don't think I have the patience to go back to the part and replay it all over again. And I don't know, I'm kind of pondering if I should just continue from where I'm at right now, which is 12 hours into the game. It's gonna be very out of place, because between those hours, a lot has happened with the game. And especially the tech stories, you know, the dreams. You know, some of it was just incredibly awesome that I just really wanted to record. But I don't know what I'm gonna do with that. If you have any suggestions, maybe if you guys really, really want to see the entire playthrough, maybe I'll replay it from the part that, you know. So, that's really my channel update. It's good to see you guys again.